16%. Dow at the same time has fallen about 18%. The stock market is now down 21%.
Arizona is still ranking second in the nation in terms of foreclosures.
We thought the foreclosure crisis had hit rock bottom. You might want to think again.
It's not even shocking anymore to hear that Arizona has a budget deficit.
The state's economic crisis is about to hit our schools again.
Arizona is already writing IOUs to pay the bills. Things are only going to get worse.
We were in a position where we were kind of running in mud. We weren't making any progress.
Every week, the revenue projections were worse. The job losses were mounting.
We had an economy that was too reliant on real estate, too reliant on growth, too reliant on back-of-house jobs that were eliminated.
Using the sports terminology that I'm so accustomed to, we needed a new game plan.
Central to that plan was going to be an effort not just to balance the budget, but to really reset the economy.
There was thought back then towards long-term. How do we create an economic growth for this state that is sustainable, that would allow Arizona to achieve its potential?
We had a very intentional strategy when we started to envision a new organization, an organization that would replace the Arizona Department of Commerce.
We knew that the state needed a strong agency that could serve business statewide to make sure that they were helping them grow, foster the development of new business, and really help people who were innovators take their ideas and move them to market more quickly.
We knew that Arizonans and Arizona policymakers wanted a level playing field. So we created an incentive structure that is just that. And it is transparent and accountable. It spells it out in the statute. It is objective.
One of the most powerful words in business is focus. So we took talented people, the resources, and put that into an organization that was solely dedicated to economic development, and great things have happened ever since.
But certainly, as the organization grew up, particularly since 2015 when Governor Ducey took over, having a business person chair that organization has really been a game changer for us.
The number one change that I saw at the ACA is that I was going to be intimately involved. I was going to be the chief spokesperson and salesperson for the state.
Our focus was on aerospace and defense, renewable energy, semiconductor and electronics, and the bioscience industry.
The ACA was super smart in going after a strategy that would bring export industries into the state. It's the magnet that everything else can grow from.
The threshold moment was a Super Bowl weekend of 2015. Over that weekend, we negotiated a $2 billion investment from Apple, and it's only accelerated.
Governor Ducey says Apple agreed to a $2 billion investment with a 30-year commitment to the state, the largest investment Apple has ever made.
Caterpillar has come to Tucson and come to Tucson in a very big way.
Infosys, a global tech company focusing on consulting and next-generation services, they selected Arizona to be the home of their new innovation hub.
Exciting news here, a brand new high-tech company came to town today. Soon, Lucid Motors is going to be making cars in Casa Grande.
It will make electric cars, creating thousands of jobs across Arizona.
The company's CEO says Governor Doug Ducey helped get this deal going years ago.
An engineering heavyweight moves its global headquarters to Tempe, and today it's open for business.
Benchmark's arrival also brought 500 new jobs to our area.
This past year, Arizona ranked second in the entire nation when it came to job growth.
Arizona has added 300,000 private sector jobs since 2015.
Now, the Mark Anthony Brewing chose to have the state-of-the-art facility here because of the support by Governor Ducey and the city and their willingness to move quickly on this project.
The state of Arizona is paving the way to improve trade with Mexico. Governor Ducey announcing today that Arizona is opening two new trade offices south of the border.
In 2015, with three other engineers, they created Footprint, a company that's transforming the food industry.
Over the last 10 years, the ACA successfully won over 950 competitive projects, with companies creating over 191,000 new projected jobs while investing over $33 billion in capital investment, far exceeding our goals.
We knew that we had a real opportunity with technology, and it started right from the get-go.
For Blue Yonder to anchor our headquarters in Arizona, ACA played a defining role. ACA brings a degree of empathy, a degree of understanding, time investment to understand our business, our requirements.
But technology is not only as a field of study, but it is as developing the skills that we know are wanted and needed by the businesses in our region. The relationship with ACA and the colleges is really important so that the colleges can understand what's in the future, what is coming, what is the work of the ACA in attracting a certain type of business.
Having Governor Ducey lead our efforts has been very instrumental in ensuring that Arizona is competitive in the global economy.
Governor Ducey confirming some major news tonight, a supplier for the tech giant Apple planning to build a chip factory here. Their name, the Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company, a leading manufacturer in chip technology.
We are increasingly seeing that technology and industrial sector are converging. It's evidenced here if you look at Honeywell is headquartered here, Intel is headquartered here, Benchmark, Insight Enterprises is headquartered here.
Today, Arizona has more jobs in manufacturing than construction, and that spells good news for Arizona's economy.
What having more manufacturing jobs than construction jobs in Arizona means is we are a diversified economy. We have high-tech jobs, semiconductor jobs, jobs across the landscape.
So that all goes into pay for schools, public safety, roads, all the infrastructure that we all use every day.
So everything you're doing within your business, within your community, it's all about making it better for our kids and our grandkids. The ACA is just another example of following through on that belief.
These are all things that say we're a better quality of life, we've got a lot of prosperity, and the ACA is knocking it out of the park as the voice of Arizona. And I only see us going farther and further because we're on our way.